Well, and for those of us who've been to Sparks games at Staples Center, I know I have, it is an in-game environment unlike any other, with professional host and hype man Frenchie leading the charge. And believe it or not, he and others are still hyping up fans before and after Sparks games, but they're doing it virtually. And for Frenchie, the journey has been very special, taking him from his hometown, New York, to Los Angeles and meeting just some incredible people along the way.
How do you describe what it is you do?
Oh, man. So what I do is, and the way I characterize my job is to make people feel good.
Come on! Hey!
Whether it's five people or 50,000 people at an arena, my job is to come in and change the energy and change the environment.
How has being a part of the Sparks family changed your life and career?
Well, working with the Sparks has been so amazing. What's so great is the WNBA gave me my first job in New York working with the Liberty. So to now be on the other side of the country, giving that same energy and also in a time where the WNBA is growing so much, it's such a great time to be with the Sparks, and they're very innovative and it's a lot of fun. Like, there's nothing like it.
I would imagine here in Los Angeles, doing what you do, you've been able to cross paths with a lot of interesting folks. Who's approached you? Who's seen you at the games and then come up to you and said, hey, keep up the good work?
I hate to say this. I hate to name drop, but since we name drop, we got to go with a big one. Jay-Z. Now, really interesting story, and I'll make it quick, but when I was in New York, one of my first internships was working for Angie Martinez as her assistant, day in, day out, just getting her news and making sure that the show was ready to go. Now, her and Jay-Z are very close friends. So when he came to L.A., he was at a game sitting courtside. Of course, I went up to him and said, you know, what's up from New York? Hi, I'm Frenchie. And he remembered, which to me, like, was on another level. I mean, listen, I'm a kid from New York City, so Jay-Z is like the mayor, for real. To have Jay-Z actually remember and actually acknowledge my work and say, hey man, you know, great job. It's like, it was a big deal. I mean, since then, everything has changed.
What's it like to walk out on the court of a big time professional basketball game and have a microphone in your hand and you can hype up the crowd? It must be incredibly empowering, I would imagine.
I love that question, because honestly, what it really is, the best way to answer it is I'm living my dream. Like, that is literally my dream. The fact that I get to go out, and when I'm on that court, there's only one thing that I'm thinking about. My parents are Haitian immigrants. So when they came here, my only opportunity to go and experience live sports was usually in the nosebleed section, in the 300 section, way up top. So when I'm on the court, that's who I have in mind. I'm thinking of that parent or that family that can't really afford the expensive seats or sit courtside.